Good afternoon, everybody. URBACT is in Brussels this week for the European Week of Regions and Cities, which is the annual event organized by the Committee of the Region and the DG for Regional and Urban Policy. This year, the event is focusing on EU cohesion policy beyond 2020. And among the main themes of the event, we have urban, regional, and territorial policy. So as you may know, URBACT is a European Territorial Cooperation Programme which promotes sustainable integrated urban development in European cities. We are here today with Ivan Tosic. Good afternoon, Ivan.
Hi, everyone.
And we are going to ask him a few questions about our new online tool. So Ivan, can you tell us more about Remaking the City?
The idea came that European cities need to change their planning approach because the cities themselves have less money and less power. And so they can less control urban development. They need more innovation regarding the spaces and people, because these two things cannot be taken away from the cities. So we tried to collect in a funny way, I would say, good URBACT practices and make it open to other cities and also awaiting their approaches. And the tool itself is an online web tool, and it is organized around five major challenges which are in space. So a empty or underused building, a underused urban space, or an area which is quite deprived, or an area which is monofunctional, industrial or garage places or a large housing estate, or an area which is really unsustainable because of environmental problems. And then if cities have such a problem, which belongs to one of these territorial challenges, then they can look to this column and they can find through the planning circle, which goes from mapping, identifying, activating, involving citizens and NGOs, till decision making, institutionalizing, mainstreaming, until monitoring and evaluating. And then if they go to these places, then they can find 5, 10, 15 good URBACT practices which are described along the innovative approach. And at the end of the description, there is also a name to which you can turn and you can ask some more details.
Okay, so why is the tool useful for urban practitioners?
Because I would say that the challenges in European cities are quite similar, and you don't have to find out everything from the beginning. So you have an idea, but you are not sure whether it is good or not, and you can turn to this tool and you can just get innovative things which maybe you didn't think about at all. So I just made a presentation about this tool here, and one of the examples was the urban commons in Naples. And the idea is very simple, that you have empty buildings which you cannot do anything with it, large, empty, sometimes in areas which are very dense and they would need a lot of functions, but you don't have money, you as a city, you don't have money to run this place. So you just offer the place to NGOs, to associations, which have ideas what to do with these buildings. So Naples developed a quite interesting structure in which if an association or NGO accepts a place, then there are rules, but there are also ideas how to run this place and how to assure that everyone has an access to the place, because you cannot make an exclusive place out of it. So it's a kind of help from the side of the city to the population, but it also activates the population. And finally, you can make a calculation how much cheaper it is to produce culture in such a place than in an official museum which is run from state money. And finally, this is an absolutely democratic solution. You can activate people, you can involve them into the functioning of the urban society. And I think this is what we need the most, make people interested, make people active to deal with the issues which are around them.
And so what are your key messages for the participants here today at the European Week?
My key message is that it is not the case that everything is lost. We have ideas. These ideas are, for the moment, coming from URBACT cities, but I would say that all European cities are full with practices which might be termed as good practice, but might also be termed as a practice which has positive and negative sides. And we have to be interested in each other's ideas. And if we are open, if we keep our eyes open and we are looking to these practices, then potentially many cities, many people here will get ideas that, hey, I also have in my city something which is interesting. And this is what URBACT hopes, that besides delivering good ideas to other cities, we will also get new cases into our tool. And we hope that after a few years, this will really be a Bible for urban developers in Europe that really full with interesting and inspirative ideas.
Thank you very much, Ivan, and thank you for listening to us. If you're in Brussels and participating in the European Week of Regions and Cities, do come see us. We are at the Urban Corner in the Agora space of the Square Conference Center. We will have more testimonies tomorrow by cities and a presentation of the program as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you.